biological science. You all know that we are living in a beautiful environment which is surrounded by many things. Can you name the things which are found in the environment? Yes. Kavya? Other than that? Okay. Wild animals will find in our environment where you live. That's it. Yourself? The things which you find in our environment, even our surrounding. Okay. That's it, you see. Nothing else in around us?
Buildings.
Building.
Horse.
Yes. Anything else you want to say? Yes? Roads. Okay, fine. Now, how about these many things? Can we classify them broader into two different types? If yes, what are those two types of major things which we find in our environment? I will not ask you only animals. I refer all the aspects which are found in every environment in general.
Biotic.
Oh, biotic and abiotic. Very good. In simpler term, what we call
living and non-living.
Now let us consider living and non-living things which were being surrounded by us. Even in our classroom meeting, if we wanted to list, we can list out both living and non-living things which are surrounded us. Right? Now let us consider the non-living things. Do non-living, all the non-living things are natural substances which are found naturally? Can you name the non-living things which are found within our classroom now? Yeah, fine. Similarly, we find the non-living things outside also. Do all these are naturally obtained? Natural substances?
No.
Then what kind of
man-made?
They are man-made also. Right? Oh, let me not give the mass answers. Whomever I point out, you can answer. Yes, non-living substances are not all man-made, like natural. They are man-made also. So what purpose, what for we use is non-living substances are the substances which are found in our nature are the man-created substances for our daily life. Okay, just imagine, all of you close your eyes. Imagine that we are all using the non-living substances or artificial substances or the naturally obtained substances for the different purposes in our life. Imagine we are using right now. After certain amount of usage, we may throw them out. What happens when we keep throwing the substances out? Just keep imagining yourself. Do we different? No. So what happens when after the death of the living organisms, like animals as well as plants? It decays. What do we call the process of decay in another way? Degradable. Biodegradable is it. Isn't it? So just imagine, in case even this living organisms also we put out become a landfill, where we could have started, where we could have lived. Gracefully, these living organisms, they are going to become biodegradable, or they will decay, or will become rotten. Okay, while decaying of this organism, do we get some amount of foul smell?
Yes.
We all feel, right? What it indicates? What do that foul smell of the decaying organisms indicates? Okay, there was a bad smell. So what may be the reason for the bad smell?
Chemical reaction.
There was some chemical reaction was going on. So when there was a chemical reaction, that means what kind of odor, the smell which is being emitted, is it enters the atmosphere?
Yes.
Okay. So that means, is there some chemicals will be added to the atmosphere?
Yes.
You all agree? Okay. So now when the living organisms die, which also got biodegradable substances, when they will be discarded, or they will die naturally, or be accidentally, they undergo the process of decay. You all know that. So in the process of decay, it emits some amount of chemicals to atmosphere. Right?
Yes.
Do all the chemicals and all the substances, whatever is there in the organism, it emits to the atmosphere?
No.
Whatever the substances had in that organism, is it everything emits to the atmosphere?
No.
So then what, where it is it goes?
Soil.
It also goes to the
soil.
So some amount of chemicals gets into the plants. hydrogen, sulfur? Do they exist in the atmosphere as it is? Or they keep moving around in a different form? It will move in a different, so think of carbon, sulfur, nitrogen. They will be in a combination with the other elements, other compounds, they will keep circulating. Right? Now, the substances which are being rendered from the like life to the earth or to the atmosphere will keep circulating one other different form in the environment. So if we want to call for such kind of circulation of substances from the earth to like atmosphere or atmosphere to life or whatever different directions. What cycle. Is it called as such kind of cycle? What kind of cycle?
Bio.
So is that, yes, someone answer?
Bio geochemical
cycle. See, here is life. So it gets into the earth and further gets into the atmosphere in form of chemicals. It will be circulating in either of the way. In today's class, let us learn about the meaning and components of biogeochemical cycles in detail in our class. Under the lesson, natural resources. Meaning. Components of